Tim. But a few words of caution before we begin. Bring no tricks and treats to your seats, for worms, mice, and cats will crawl by your feet. Should a sound from your phone you make, into the cauldron, I shall seal your fate. Be warned, monsters are out of their crypts and graves. So in the face of danger, remember to be brave. Or should you need to run and flee, look around and fly out of the closest exit you see. Now prepare yourself for a bewitching tale of a young girl who learns why Halloween never fails. To bring spooky mayhem, it always delivers. But beware, you might find yourself with the case of the Shivers.
You know what? You're right. girl.
Boy, shouldn't get to have all the fun, should they?
Let me start over. Once upon a time, there was a girl named Roberta.
What? Really?
See you later.
Roberta looked like a normal girl, but there was something very different about her.
Was she pretty?
What do you think? How do you see her?
I think she's very pretty.
I do too.
Roberta looked like a normal girl who was very pretty, but there was something very different about her. Roberta had been born without the ability to feel afraid. Her friends and her family were scared all the time. They lived in Transylvania. You see, a land filled with dark forests and spooky old castles and graveyards. And they were scared of anything and everything. But nothing scared Roberta. The truth is, she simply didn't know how to feel afraid.
Roberta, come inside! It's getting late!
There's still an hour before the sun goes down.
Only an hour? The hobgoblins will be out any minute.
Hobgoblins can only come out at night, Mother. You said so yourself. And why should a hobgoblin bother me anyway?
They steal children. They carry them off to their underground lairs and make slaves out of them. Do you really want to end up in some deep, dark tunnel digging rocks for the rest of your days?
Hobgoblins only steal little kids, Mother, because their lairs are so tiny. I'm too big for one to kidnap. Besides, I've never seen a hobgoblin. I'm curious as to what one looks like.
Good grief! The child's not afraid of hobgoblins. I thought I raised you to have some sense.
I think a person can be perfectly sensible without being afraid of hobgoblins.
What about werewolves, then? You know these forests are full of werewolves. One might come by and look.
We have chickens and pigs, Mother. And the cow. If a werewolf could have his choice of chicken, pork, or beef, why would it want to eat meat? Besides, it's a scientific fact that wolves don't attack humans. That's a misconception. Wolves are actually afraid of humans.
We're not talking about regular wolves. These are werewolves. Men who turn into wolves and run around doing bad things like eating up little girls.
For one thing, I'm not that little anymore. If a werewolf tried to eat me, I'd probably stick it in its throat and it would choke. Secondarily, you said that werewolves can only transform on ice if the moon is full. And look, the moon is only half full. No werewolves.
What about vampires? Vampires don't need a full moon to come out of their graves.
I'm wearing my cross. And I had garlic on my bread at lunch.
I just can't understand you, Roberta. All your brothers and sisters are properly terrified, as all children should be. But you, you're not afraid of anything. I worry so much for you.
I don't mean to worry, Mother. I'm sorry I'm not like everybody else. I just don't understand why everyone's so jumpy all the time. I'll try really hard, I promise, to figure out how to be scared.
Your father's up.
Father?
Cousin, what happened? Oh, it was terrible. There were a few times I thought I had you for sure.
One almost had you.
A bard chased me all the way from Bristmilla did.
Oh, no, not a bard. I told you not to take that shortcut to the hollow.
I thought it would be safe.
It's called Bogart Hollow. Isn't it? Hello? You think that would have tipped you off?
Biggest bugger I've ever seen.
Father? What's in this bag?
Oh, it's your mother's cornmeal for tonight's bread.
Oh, my poor husband! Almost devoured by a boggart!
I meant the boggart was just hungry.
That's what I was afraid of!
I meant hungry for the cornmeal. You should have given it a little bit.
What? Stop and feed a hungry boggart? I swear, daughter, where do you get such ideas?
In this other bag. Full of salt, isn't it? You always said that boggarts are great salt. You really wanted to get
father.
Oh, I was too scared to stop.
Oh no, I think! Your eyes is twice as great as it was when you left home this morning. Let's get you inside. It's almost sundown. Every ghost and goblin and bugger and beast in all creation will be out on the prowl. You get inside too, young lady. I mean it.
Yes, mother. Hello? Is someone there? Oh, hi. You fought on them, didn't you? It's all right. You can jump closer. I won't hurt you. You just want something to eat, don't you? Here. Can't give you too much. Mother needs it to make tonight's supper. There's nothing scary about you at all, is there? Mother and father say that I should be scared of you, but I don't see why. You don't bite. And even if you did, I'd just avoid you. Seems simple enough to me. Everybody always says there's something wrong with me because I never get scared. I wish I could get scared. I do it just to make other people happy. I ask people how it's done, but nobody can tell me. They all say it just comes naturally. Well, not to me, it doesn't. There has to be somebody out there who can teach me how to be afraid. That's what I need. A good case of the shivers. You know what? I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go out there and find out how to be afraid. I can't wait to get good and scared. That'll be so cool.
You should probably run along now. You're liable to scare mother and father into
hysterics. Oh, I hope I get hysterics.
Three nights in the castle and survive would
inherit half the king's kingdom.
Half? Seriously?
What do you think?
Sounds fair to me.
Half the kingdom. Oh my gosh.
That's a lot of kingdom, Your Majesty.
You're telling me.
Half?
That's what she said.
Oh my gosh.
You should be a handsome prince too. A handsome prince for a Brutus to marry. That's how these things are supposed to go.
Okay. There was a handsome prince.
I have a son now?
Just go with it, my lord.
Are you serious? Don't look at me. I'm not the one rewriting the story.
Well, why can't you have a son and a daughter?
Yeah!
Minister? I see no reason why you shouldn't, sire.
I'm afraid the story only calls for one royal offspring. I am the only princess!
Yeah!
Does that work for you?
It has to be a prince. Sorry. So, I have to leave?
Yeah! Yeah.
No!
Prince, so your highness.
Well, I never. I am calling my agent. A fairy tale without a princess in it? Who ever heard of such a thing? This would have never happened if I had signed with it had
dark, and Roberto was beginning to have second thoughts.
Maybe this wasn't such a good idea.
She wasn't afraid, was she?
I'm not afraid. I'm hungry.
Roberta hadn't brought any food with her, or money either, and there weren't any places around for her to buy the things she had.
You gotta give me something here. I'm starving.
All right. How about this? A wagon load of gypsies came by and took pity on a fellow traveler.
Delicious.
up there in the wind like that. Hold on. I'll try to get you down. There now. Get you close to the fire.
Ah, what are you trying to do? Cremate me?
Sorry, I thought you were cold.
I'm a revenant. I don't get cold.
What's a revenant?
Yeah, what's a revenant?
A revenant is a dead body that has become animated again, as opposed to a ghost, which is a spirit without a body.
So, you're a body without a spirit. Wait, I thought that was a vampire.
I thought that was a zombie. No. Vampires drink blood. That's gross. And zombies seem to have a taste for brains. That's even more gross. I'm just a regular.
So, you don't drink blood, and you don't eat brains. What do you do?
I scare you. Aren't you scared?
Why should I be? You just said you don't drink blood or eat brains.
But I'm the angry dead body of a hanged criminal.
What are you so angry about?
What? Did you just miss the part where I said I got hanged?
Didn't you also say that you were a criminal? What'd you do that made you a criminal?
Lots of things. I was a bandit and a murderer. Oh, and I do this thing where I took over student house.
Particularly.
Do you know
zombie vampires and revenants.
Then you know that they'll bite you and suck your blood.
Only if I let you, and I don't intend to.
Your garlic breath won't last all night. As soon as it wears off, I'll bite you.
Oh, I also brought this. Vampires are afraid of crosses, right? I suppose you could fight someone else, though. I better destroy you just to make sure. Nothing personal.
Roberta chased the vampire back into its crypt and placed the crucifix over the door so that I couldn't escape. Then, she got a good night's sleep. In the morning, Roberta opened the door to the crypt, and the sunlight caused the vampire to disintegrate.
There will now be a 15-minute intermission.
Granted leave to try, but in good conscience, I feel I must warn you. Many brave men have tried and failed to spend even a single night in my castle and paid for it with their lives. I urge you to reconsider.
Nonsense. I am committed.
As it pleases you, don't say I didn't warn you.
Now then, the rules of the curse state that you may take with you three things into the castle each night.
I need nothing but my strong arm and my sword.
Oh, this isn't going to end well.
Okay, I go now to your palace. Lock me inside. In the morning, you will find me hale, hearty, and ready for some breakfast.
The young lady will spend the night in the haunted castle.
And the next 2 nights.
And the next 2 nights, provided you survive the first.
Which she won't.
Which you won't.
Which I will.
You can take with you 3 things into the castle.
3 legions of knights to protect her.
3 non-living things.
3 things. Let's see. Food. I'm going to always bring food. And I guess a knife to cut my food with. Oh, and wood for a fire. I'm sure it gets cold in the haunted castle at night.
Wise choices. Minister, see that she gets these things.
And thus, despite the wishes of the king and the protests of Prince George, it was decided that Roberta would spend the night in the haunted palace. The day wore on.
I bet Roberta spent lots of time with her friends, didn't she?
In fact, she did. They went horseback riding, and went for a long walk in the royal gardens, and ate a splendid lunch.
You're making all this up as you go along, aren't you?
You're the one who wanted to change the hero to a girl. It requires a bit of ad-libbing.
I like everything better.
I'm glad. Anyway, the book says, the day wore on, and the sun began to lower in the sky. A chill crept into the air. At last, night had fallen. Roberta, was escorted by the prince to the haunted castle.
Please reconsider.
Don't worry, I got this.
And locked in for the night.
Self-hide. makes you feel any better about it? I'm disappointed too. I was really hoping you could scare me.
Hold up. You want to be scared?
Uh-huh.
But you're not scared.
I'm afraid not.
This would have to happen on my shift.
What do you mean your shift?
We all take turns. I never go first. Usually, I never get a turn. By the time it's my turn, poor Trump is usually frightened to death.
Who is?
Whatever Dumbo is or was trying to spend the night here in this castle. Come to think of it, we've never seen a girl in here before. You are, a girl, aren't you? It's been a long time since we have seen one.
Yes, my name's Roberta.
Well, Roberta, it's obvious you're not scared of me. Since it looks like you might just make it till morning, let me give you some advice. Count yourself lucky. Don't dare to spend a second night here in this castle. Tomorrow night, it's the cat's turn.
Cats?
And the king of the ghouls.
Who's the king of the ghouls?
King is kind of an honorary title. She's the scariest of all ghouls, that's for sure, and the oldest, so she wanted to be called the king, and we weren't gonna argue.
What's a ghoul? I know that a revenant scares people, and vampires drink blood, and zombies eat brains, but what do ghouls do?
They eat you, all of you, gobble you right up, clothes and all. Be warned, you don't want to encounter the king of the ghouls.
Ooh! After the visit from the disembodied head, the night passed without further incident.
Lovely morning, Minister.
Indeed it is.
Birds are chirping, flowers blooming, and all.
Alas, the poor girl, frozen solid with fright like all the rest. I blame myself for this. I should never have allowed her to spend the night in this awful place.
Good morning.
Ah, you're alive.
Ah, you're alive. Sure I am. Now, how's about some breakfast?
Day with the prince. It was pleasant in the extreme, but unfortunately, it passed so quickly. Soon, it was time for Roberta to spend her second night in the haunted castle.
Enormous black cats appeared. Their green eyes glowed like cold fire in the night.
Wake up, little Missy. This is no time for resting.
No, this night is a night of games and sports.
If you say so.
How about a little wager then? Make me more interesting.
My parents always told me not to gamble.
Just a friendly little wager.
All right, if you insist. What should we play for?
How about
your soul?
Yeah, if we win, we get your soul.
That seems a little silly. I mean, you're cat, right? What use could you possibly have for a soul? Besides, Jim, I win. Now, go chase giant rats or something.
This is your fault. You were the one who signed me up for this job.
Hey. think you left something in your pocket. There, in the corner. Right there. Look.
The curse is broken.
known this guy for what? 3 days?
Okay. How about this? In the morning, the king proclaimed the curse to be broken.
The curse is broken.
That Roberta would inherit half the kingdom.
She'll get half the kingdom.
And that she and the prince would hang out.
They'll hang out.
That's okay with me.
What happened to all the goats then? They have to go out. That hardly seems fair.
Oh, don't worry. I worked out a deal for them. They can stay as long as they promise not to scare anyone anymore.
The ghosts, however, had one last surprise for Roberta.
That water's freezing.
Oh, I get it.
Thanks, guys. Thanks. You know, I might not have found out how to be a brave, but I sure know what it's like to have a case of the shivers.
We just have to keep it down so we don't wake Mom.